Good morning, students. Today's session will be on cycloconverters. Now, what is a cycloconverter? A cycloconverter is somewhat like an AC voltage controller. It is an AC to AC converter. In a AC voltage controller, we convert a AC voltage of fixed magnitude, fixed frequency to an AC voltage of variable magnitude without a change in frequency. Whereas in a cycloconverter, we can vary both the magnitude as well as the frequency. A cycloconverter is a direct frequency changer without an intermediate DC link. Now, where does this cycloconverter comes into application? Well, the cycloconverter is used for the control of AC motors. It is used to drive large motors in rolling mills, in cement factories, in water pump industries, etc. Frequency is used by means of cycloconverters. It is reduced to drive heavy load. Frequency is increased to drive light loads. Let's go to the page. Here we can see a cycloconverter provides an AC output with a change in frequency of an AC input. This can also be achieved by an AC to DC converter. This change of frequency can also be achieved by an AC to DC converter and a DC to AC inverter. That is, it is having an intermediate DC link, but a cycloconverter does not need an intermediate DC link, just as I have already mentioned. And the frequency is changed directly by AC to AC conversion. The output frequency is always a fraction of the input frequency or a multiple of it. And a cycloconverter is generally used for speed control of AC motors, for driving large motors, as I've already said, to drive heavy loads by reducing the frequency, to drive light loads by increasing the frequency. And it can control both voltage and frequency simultaneously. Now, classifications of cycloconverters are based on two factors. First of all, on the basis of frequency, if we step down the frequency, if the frequency is reduced, we call it a step down cycloconverter. And if the frequency is increased, we call it a step up cycloconverter. And depending upon the input supply voltage and the output supply output voltage obtained, we can classify it again as single phase to single phase cycloconverter, three phase to single phase cycloconverter, and three phase to three phase cycloconverter. Now, this is a basic circuit of a single phase to single phase cycloconverter. We have a fixed frequency AC supply here. This is a positive converter group. We have a thyristor here, which is representing a positive converter group. Here's the load. This is a negative converter group represented by a thyristor again. And we obtain a variable frequency output across the load. Now here we can see a full wave topology, full wave midpoint type cycloconverter. Here we have P group and N group, that is positive group and negative group of thyristors. Here we can see that this is the input waveform and this waveform is the output waveform. That is, here this is my this is my Vs, that is the source voltage, and this is my V0, that is the voltage obtained across the output. Now, here T1 is fired at a particular angle alpha. So P group of thyristors is on during this instant, that is for two complete cycles, P group is switched on, and another for two complete cycles of the input supply, the negative group is on. So here T1 is switched on at this particular firing angle, T2 is switched on at another pi plus alpha firing angle, T1 is again switched on here, T2 is again switched on here, and we get this waveform across the output load. And similarly, T3 and T4 are switched on, and we get the negative half of the output in this form. See, so this is the fundamental output which we are getting. Now, firing angle, here we can see that we are getting 1, 2, 3, and 4 complete cycles of the input supply. So for 4 complete cycles of the input supply, we are getting 1 complete cycle of the output supply. So we can write F0 is equal to F/4, and the firing angle can be modulated to reduce harmonics in this fashion. The firing angle can be changed for each of the thyristors in order to reduce harmonics. So this is a midpoint type full wave single phase to single phase cycle converter. Now, this is also a full wave topology, bridge topologies for a single phase to single phase cycloconverter. Here we have the P group thyristors, here we have the N group thyristors. P group and N group have equal and opposite outputs by firing angle control. Both these groups cannot be on together, as this that will lead to a short circuit of the supply, and one group is on at a time. So here we can see that when P1 and P2 are on at the same instant, so when P1 and P2 are on at the same instant, the path of flow of current when this is positive and this is negative, P1 and P2 are applied a firing pulse, gate pulse. So the path will be here, here, through the load, through P2, and then back to this point. So here P1 and P2 are fired at the same instant, and after pi interval P3 and P4 are fired. P group is on for a certain interval, and again after a certain interval N group is on, and we will be getting a step down cycloconverter by controlling the firing of the thyristors in the fashion as we had seen for the midpoint single phase to single phase cycloconverter. Now, we will be seeing how a step up cycloconverter functions. For a step up midpoint cycloconverter, first we will be considering So here we can see that this is A point, this is B point, and this is the midpoint of the center tap transformer O. It is connected to the load in this fashion. This is the P group transistors, P1 and P2, and these are the N group transistors, N1 and N2. Now this is the AC envelope. This is the AC waveform envelope. Here this is the positive cycle, and here this is the negative envelope which we are showing. Now here what happens, when this is positive with respect to this terminal, that is during the positive half cycle, what happens is that this terminal is positive and this terminal is negative. So if P1 is given a gate pulse, P1 will start to conduct. So the path will be through P1, this path, this, through the load, this, and here back. Now again, so we are getting, see, at the output, at the output we are getting this portion across the output load. In the positive envelope, we are getting the output across the load. Now here in the positive half itself, when this is negative and this when this is positive and this is negative, then what happens, when this terminal is positive and this is negative, I mean this terminal is at a higher potential with respect to this terminal during the positive half cycle itself. So the path will be just as I had said, during the positive half cycle, this is positive, this is negative. So this is positive, this is negative, means this terminal positive with respect to this. This is at higher potential with respect to B. So this is at a higher potential with respect to this, and this is at a higher potential with respect to this. So here at the point O is at a higher potential with respect to point B. So now the current will flow through this path. Here, this this, then from this point downwards through N2 and back here. So if this is the path of current flow, what will be the output? The output will be the obtained across the negative envelope. So the output will be obtained across this negative envelope. So this goes on similarly again for P1. So what we are obtaining here is that this P1, this is for N2, again this is again for P1, this portion is for N2, this is for P1, this is for N2, and in the negative half cycle P2 and N1 will conduct and we will be obtaining waveforms for this portion which is darkened. See here, these are the darkened portions. So this portions we are obtaining. Now the total time period we can see for the source voltage, for the source waveform, input waveform is Ts is equal to 1 by Fs. Now but in the output waveform, we are getting waveform which are having a time period of this. So this is a complete cycle. It is starting here and it is ending here. Again, it is starting here and it is ending here. So the time period of the output T0, if it starts here, it will be here at this point, it will be a complete full cycle. So T0 is equal to 1 by F0. So this becomes a step up cycle converter. Similarly, this is a bridge convert bridge configuration, and for the bridge configuration the devices which are conducting together are P1, P2 as shown here forming the positive envelope during the output, N1, N2, N1 and N2 during the negative envelope. If they are fired during the positive half cycle itself, again P1, P2 during the positive half cycle itself, P1, P2 are is again fired, again during the positive half cycle itself N1 and N2 is fired. Now we have to remember one thing, when this negative group thyristors are fired, the positive group thyristors are getting forced commutated. They are getting forced commutated and reverse bias is appearing across these thyristors, and these thyristors are getting switched off. They're getting turned off. And again, we have to apply gate pulse at this instant to turn the thyristors on. And for the negative half cycle, the thyristors which are conducting are P3, P4 from the P group, from the positive group, and N3 and N4 from the negative group. Now this is three phase to single phase full bridge full wave cycloconverter. Here again we have P1, P1, P3, P5, and P2, sorry, P4 and P6. Okay. similarly for this. And this is a three-phase to single-phase half-wave cycle converter. We are getting for the P group, we are having three thyristors, and for the N group, we are again having three thyristors. Whereas here, we had six thyristors for each group in bridge configuration, and this was half. So this was the three-phase to single-phase half-wave cycle converter, and that was the bridge full wave, and this was the half wave where we were having three and three for P group and N group converters. Now here, this is a bit, you have to understand it, listen to me carefully to understand this waveform. Now here we are having a three-phase waveform, as you can see. This is my phase A. This is VA. This is VB. And this is VC. So we are getting three waveforms here, which are shifted from each other by an angle of 120 degrees. Now, if at the output, this is a step down cycloconverter, three phase to single phase step down cycloconverter. Now, if by any means we want to obtain a single phase output where the frequency will be 1/8 of the supply frequency, then what we have to do is we have to just remember this. I'll explain it to you as we go on. The magnitude of progressive change in firing angle will be reduction factor in frequency. Reduction factor in frequency means 1/8 we want to reduce the frequency by. If we reduce the frequency by 1/4, then we will put it as 1/4. If we reduce the frequency by 1/6, we will put it as 1/6. So here we are taking it as 1/8. So 1/8 into 120 degree, as this is the phase difference between each waveform, so that gives us 15 degree. Now at A, at the very first firing angle at point A, alpha, that is the firing angle, will be 90 degree. At B, angle will be 90 minus 15, 75 degree. At C, the firing angle will be 75 minus 15 degree, that is 60 degree. At C, the angle, the firing angle will be equal to 60 minus another 15 degree, that is 45 degree. Now this will go on, and finally at G, the firing angle will be equal to 0 degree. So that we will see how it is coming. See here, we had VA, VB and VC. So the firing angle is from this particular point. Firing angle is starting to count from this particular point. So from here to here, this is an angle of 90 degree. Again, from this point to this point, this is an angle of 90 minus 15, that is 75 degree. Again, from this point this point to this point, this is an angle of 75 minus 15, that is 60 degree. Again, from this point to this point, this is an angle of 45 degree, 60 minus 15. Again, from this point to this point, this is 45 minus 15, that is 13 degree. Again, from this 30 degree. Again, from this point to this point, this is 30 minus 15, that is equal to 15 degree. Again, from this point, it's 15 minus 15, that's alpha is equal to 0 degree, which is written here. That is alpha is equal to 0 degree. So this firing angle progressively reduces by 15 degree, which is the reduction factor depending upon the amount of reduction in frequency which is desired. And similarly, this progression increase, there will be increase in progression similarly by an angle of 15 degree, that is after alpha. This from here, this point to this point, there will be an angle, firing angle of 15 degree. From this point, there will be firing angle of another 15 plus 15, that is 30 degree. From this point to this point, it will be 45 degree. From this point, this will be 60 degree. And from this point, this will be 75 degree, and so on. So I haven't shown the negative, the total cycle, the negative cycle. And this is the fabricate mean output voltage, this dotted lines, and this dark waveforms. This is the fabricated output voltage from where we will get the mean output voltage. Hope this is clear for all of you. Now, you can see that this is the output current waveform. This was the output voltage waveform, input voltage. These were the input voltages, and this were the output voltages, the fabricated output voltage and the mean output voltage. And this was the output current. This was an RL load, and this was the output current. Now, for the output current, this current is lagging the voltage by certain angle. Now, from this point C, from A point to from to this point, to this point, this current is negative, but the mean output voltage is positive. So here there will be inversion, and from this point to this point, both current and voltage is positive, so there will be rectification. Okay, that was how we were changing the angles, and we were obtaining an output waveform. Here also, see, just keeping the P group on and by modulating the firing angle, we are also obtaining a output voltage, three phase to single phase cyclo converter. This is a three phase to three phase cyclo converter. This is a P group, this is the N group. For each group, there are three thyristors. For N group, there is again three thyristor. This is the phase A load. So we can see for this three phase to three phase cyclo converter, we require a total of 18 thyristors. Here three, so total 6 threes are 18. So we require a total of 18 thyristors. Now, there are two types of operation of cycloconverters. One is blocked group operation and another is circulating mode operation. For blocked group operation, for any cycloconverter, it is imperative that the P group rectifying elements and N group rectifying elements cannot be on simultaneously. That I have mentioned previously itself, that because that will lead to short circuit of the source. Now, the firing circuit is firing circuit and the firing angle is so modulated that neither of the groups will be on simultaneously. Now this will involve that we block one group until current stops in the other group. Now as for resistive loads, the voltage and the currents are in phase. By firing angle control of the output voltage, this is easily possible. But for inductive load, the firing control of the groups follow the output current with rectifying and inverting modes for each group. This I have already mentioned. This is the output for inductive load. This is the voltage, this is the current. So this is was inverting here because the voltage was positive but current was negative. This was rectifying as the voltage and current both were positive. Here voltage was negative but current was positive, so this was inversion. And from the total where the current was positive, here the positive group was conducting. And again from this point to this point where both voltage and current is negative, this was a rectifying operation. Now this is circulating current mode. Circulating current mode, what we do, we connect an intergroup reactor where both groups can conduct simultaneously, and this intergroup reactor, it limits the circulating current levels. Here we connect an intergroup reactor. How many current circulates through the reactor and fundamental flows through the load? Here no feedback current is needed to inhibit as in blocked group operation, and both the P and on N rectifiers can be on simultaneously, but there is a disadvantage also. SCR will carry both circulating and load current, so SCR have to be overrated from the load, and load only has to take the fundamental component, useful only for light loads as thyristors have to be overrated. And changing firing angle, voltage also changes, but frequency control is not as fast as voltage control. So students, this is our chapter on cycloconverters, whatever we have in our syllabus. Hope this was easy to understand. Please subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos to come. If you have any doubt, you can post your comments in the channel. And look out for more videos on power electronics. Thank you.